Well, good morning, folks, and welcome to Goodwill, Oklahoma and Panhandle State University as we get ready to present to you our 2018 edition of our Homecoming Parade. We welcome you and we thank everybody for joining us. It's going to be a great day. Of course, we've got the tailgate party afterwards and great football action against Wayland Baptist coming up at 2 o'clock this afternoon. My name is Derek Barton. I am the voice of your OPSU Aggies, and it's a pleasure to be here. And joining me on the microphone for our coverage today is, of course, Danae Moore. And, you know, Danae, last year we were in jackets and caps here, so you couldn't ask for a better day here for a great parade.
We definitely couldn't. It's a gorgeous day. We want to thank you guys for coming out. We'd like to tell PTCI a special thanks for filming for us. You can catch this again on Channel 2. And thank you, Derek, for joining me to host.
Always a pleasure. And we are excited. We've got about 40 entries, roughly, in our parade this year. So great excitement here. And, folks, these are your friends. These are your neighbors. These are your sons, your daughters, your granddaughters, and grandsons that are part of this parade for today. So when you see them, let them know that you're out there supporting. We hope that you'll join us for the tailgate party. This is going to be a lot of fun. Got some great businesses and vendors out there. And, of course, the big football game coming up at 2 o'clock this afternoon. Now, we know at our opening game we had some issues with the weather and stuff. But for you people who can hear us on the PA system, just by your applause, how many were able to go to the first home football game that we had here on the new field? What did you think of that new field and that new video board? Is that great for all of us here at Panhandle State? Man, that brings us up to the next level, and we are so excited for everything that we've got. A lot of great things happening in athletics and in academics here. 9% increase in enrollment this year. That is just astronomical, and great things by all of our faculty and staff and recruiters and everybody bringing people here to OPSU. As we look down the parade route right here, we're led by our law enforcement, the people that put themselves in the line of fire for our protection each and every day. You know, when you're in your daily life, take time and stop and think of a firefighter, a police officer, a sheriff's deputy, a soldier, for all that they do for protecting our freedom. Following right behind our police, looks like we've got our color guard. That is courtesy of Lone Wolf District of the Golden Spread Council, Boy Scouts of America. And remember, scout me in as they present our colors. Thank you to the Boy Scouts, and of course, right there in the beautiful top-down cruise along, Dr. Fulton, Mrs. Fulton, and the family, good morning to you, folks. It's a great day to be an Aggie. Thank you. You got that right.
Following Dr. Fulton, we have Mr. and Miss Panhandle State.
Nice job, gang. Congratulations.
Next up, we have the Fiesta King and Queen, Daniel and Sharon. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for joining us, gang. We appreciate it. Beautiful car right there. Can't beat a good convertible. And, of course, our emergency medical services. Goodwill, thank you, folks. These are the folks that are out there supporting us. They're here during the football games, all of our sporting events. We thank them, and of course, our Goodwill Fire Department. Like I said, these are the guys that are protecting our homes, our ranches, our farms. When Mother Nature decides that they're going to cause some problems, these are the ones we call on. So thank you, gang. We greatly appreciate it, and thanks for being a part of our parade today. Is that Chris? What's happening, dude? You're out. 9 times out of 10, I'd have never caught that. Thank you again, Texas County firefighters. Hey, Andre, how are you this morning? You're supposed to throw that candy, not eat all of it. Texoma Fire Department here, engine one, beautiful pumper truck right there. Good morning to you, gang. Thanks for being here.
Ashley Linhart is a lifelong resident of the Panhandle. She is a teacher at Turpin High School, and she and her husband John own an ag business. Together they have two children, Riley and Jackson, who attend public school at Turpin. She graduated from Panhandle State in 2002. Thanks, Ashley.
Of course, we've got, there he is. Chase, good morning to you, bud. PTCI, of course, great supporters of us here out at Panhandle State. They are, of course, going to be carrying our broadcast later on Channel 2 of our parade coverage, and they cover our games. Great job. So a big thanks goes out to one of our great corporate partners, PTCI.
Next up, we have the Guymon High School Band. Let's go, Tigers.
Let's hear it.
Here come our Aggie Spirit Riders, Erica Chartrand and Riley Shore. Hey, girls.
And right behind them, seven-time national champion, back-to-back national champions. Won the girls, won the rodeo last weekend at Kirby.
Oops, we clipped out.
Your OPSU rodeo team, guys, congratulations. Have another great season. Oh, incoming. Mr. Etbauer, Ms. Shelby. Oh, by the way, in case you didn't see it, the lady back here, our assistant coach, just recently engaged. Congratulations.
She's going to kill me. This is the all-ag organization. You got a friend in me?
This is our all-ag float right here. You got a friend in me? You got Woody right there. To infinity and beyond.
The Steggy family is our 2018 alumni honored family coming down the street right now.
We will be telling you more about that. Of course, they will have the tree dedication. I believe they've...
At 11:45.
11:45, they'll be doing the tree dedication for our honored family. We'll introduce you to some of them during our football game, but thank you, folks. Welcome to the parade and all that you have done for Panhandle State as well, carrying on the tradition there. I think they said from like 1930-something to 2014, alumni through the Panhandle State, so thank you, gang. We greatly appreciate it. Next one up, we've got our Texas County Democratic Party members supporting the Congressional District number 3 and statewide Democratic candidates. Of course, lots of time. Voice, make your voice heard. Get out and vote this year.
Let's hear it for our red and blue. Go Aggie cheer. Looking good, No Man Dan.
Again, the Aggie cheer squad under the direction of new head coach Alyssa Freeman. They have been doing great things here. We're getting ready to look at competitive cheer coming up as well. Some great things. So thanks to our Aggie cheer squad. It's an honor to work with these folks each and every event that we have here. Thank you.
Let's switch it on over to the purple and gold and the Goodwill Eagles. We've got the Little Giants coming down to the street with our sixth grade float.
Again, a big thanks goes out to Goodwill Schools and their programs being big supporters of us and, of course, being a part of the new football stadium, our new turf and video board.
Let's see it, Little Giants.
Red 42, set, hup, hup. Oh Lord, that does make me feel old. Wow. Oh, yeah, Adrian. It's the seventh grade right here. Yep, Aggies knock him out. Rocky Balboa.
Hey, Fred. God, looking at these, 2023 is like, oh, God, I am old. I'll be in a home by that time.
2023. Here's the class of 2023. Goodwill Eagles.
Oh, I got a little Bubba Gump up there, huh? I just felt like running. Is that Jenny? Is that my Jenny? All right, I like that. Staying with the 90s theme right there. Mama always said, you got to support the Aggies, right? Is that No Man, or is that Dan? Lieutenant Dan.
We're flashing back to the 90s with a time capsule and the freshman class.
Oh, yeah. Wayne's World. Party on, Garth. Who's that guy up there playing saxophone? Never mind. We'll stay out of that.
Oh, I like that. Richard Simmons.
They did a little bit of homework right there for the 90s. Richard Simmons right there, Scream movie, Wayne's World. I like that. Good job, guys. We want to say a big thanks goes out to all of our judges down here to my left. Keeping an eye on things, we'll announce the winners of our float. We'll announce our winner at the football game later on this afternoon. All right, sophomore class, let me guess. Joey, Rachel, Monica. There's Monica. Okay. Where's Ross? There's Ross. Should have known. Guy had the dinosaur. Should have. Friends right there. Thanks, gang. Nice job right there. Nice job. Staying with the theme. That's what we like to see. Yeah, can't touch this. Come on, guys. They're dancing. You're not. Okay, on second thought, don't ever do that again.
That was your senior class, I guess. Okay. Yeah, it should be.
Seniors, is that you rounding it out for us?
Yep.
We have our freshman homecoming candidates, Kylie Slavin and Isaac Bradford. The sophomore candidates are Max Klar and Roxana Yabara. Tyron Rose and Dally Simmons are the junior candidates, and Jordan Lisi and Kale Halliburton, Tiana Boley and Bodie Grice, Nick Silva and Brittany Franklin are our senior homecoming candidates. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, gang, for being here. Oh, sure, you guys get the nice little BMW convertible, don't you? I saw him last night. You were helping with the music, weren't you? Nice job, dude.
All right, Mario Brothers right here. The SOEA. Club organization here on campus, very active. It's good to see y'all.
Yep, they've got the sound effects going. I can hear them right there as they get by. Yep, Mario Brothers. Right here, we've got the horse and buggy, courtesy of Zach's Cheese, down on Main Street in Guymon. Tell you what, if you have not gone in there, I've gone in there many times. Cheese curds, they've got beef sticks, all sorts of goodies, party platters. If you've got events coming up, they can get you all taken care of. So thanks to Zach's Cheese for being here.
Panhandle State Color Guard.
OPSU band, of course, you'll see them on the field. Special presentation at halftime today. We'll tell you the history and that we're finally seeing this great program back here at OPSU. And there is our Guymon ambassadors. They are great supporters of everything. They're going around to all functions, openings, you name it. So gang, thanks for being here. Good to see you.
Panhandle State NAFME, the National Association for Music Education.
Always an important one right there for music education. We thank them for being here as well.
Miss Texoma, Macy Castle.
And for U.S. Congressional District 3, Democratic candidate Frankie Robbins for the Congressional District 3 invites you to vote and meet him at the tailgate area after the parade. Thank you for joining us. As I've always said, you can't gripe if you don't get out and vote, so make your voice be heard.
We're flashing back to the 90s again with the Panhandle Hispanic Alumni Float, Remembering Selena. They had an awesome event a couple weeks ago at Honey's, and we're very excited to see the things that they're going to do in the future.
Now I understand why you said you had to be dressed this way today. Now it makes sense. Takes a while for me.
We've got Phi Beta Lambda celebrating flashback to the 90s as well with the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air inspired float. And they're all about the Aggies beating the Pioneers today.
And our next one, Aim to Win. I like that. Our shooting sports gang right here. We are looking forward to have our shooting sports part of OPSU here. And it's going to be an exciting time. So thank you, gang. We appreciate it. Nice job on the fire last night, by the way, Mr. Brent. If you missed the bonfire, it got raging last night. It was a lot of fun. So to everybody who came out, we greatly appreciate it. And a big thanks. We got Bank of the Panhandle. I love that car. You can see that thing coming forever. Of course, hey, you were in our video the other day. Nice job, by the way. You'll see it on the big screen here in just a little bit.
Kenton Patskowski for State House.
Oh, there you go. Get it, man. There you go.
Man, you hurt your record.
And wrapping it up with our law enforcement, bringing everything up, cleaning things up on the backside. Well, looking down the parade route, folks, that looks like it is going to do it for our parade. Big thanks again to PTCI for videoing our event. You can see that on Channel 2 coming up later on. And, of course, we invite everybody to make your way back behind Anchor D Arena here. And we've got our tailgate party. Get ready. We've got football action coming up at 2 o'clock this afternoon as your OPSU Aggies take on Wayland Baptist for our homecoming gang. Thanks for coming out. We'll see you at the tailgate. Have a great day. On behalf of Danae Moore, this is Derek Barton saying, till next time, BBFN, bye-bye for now.
All right, welcome to Homecoming 2018. We had the most amazing parade just now. It's a beautiful day, very festive atmosphere. One of the best parts of Homecoming at OPSU is the honored family. And man, have we got a good one today. So we've got the Stedgy family. They have 28 degrees over history. 28 people who come through, 15 degrees over history. So that's 80 years of the Stedgy family coming to Oklahoma, Panhandle State University. They came from Norway originally. Ultimately, they settled in Oslo. And man, are we proud of them. Look at that. You can see generations upon generations. You got some good looking folks in the back. And we are just so honored that you're part of this day. Well, like I said, you all represent what we're all about. So thank you so much. I hope you enjoy the day. Hope you enjoy the game. We'll see you at the beginning of the game. We're so excited about that. I want to say thank you to PTCI. We couldn't do so many things without their wonderful support. Thank you so much.
We have some special guests with us today for Inside OPSU, Mr. and Miss Panhandle State, the newly crowned. Congratulations.
Thank you, Danae.
Thank you.
All right, Hannah, go ahead and introduce yourself. Tell us a little bit about how you found your way to Panhandle State.
My name is Hannah Johnson, and I am a junior history major here at OPSU. I'm from Texoma, Oklahoma, so when I found the opportunity to continue cheering in history in the Panhandle, I took it with no hesitation.
And you really haven't looked back since. You're super involved on campus. You have
I am.
A busy day today.
Yes, yes. I'm also on homecoming court, so.
Awesome.
It's quite busy.
Okay, Lucas, while she is very local, 10 miles away, you come from a little bit farther. Tell us about yourself as well.
Okay, my name is Lukáš Holub. I'm from the Czech Republic in Europe, which is right next to Germany and Poland and Slovakia and Austria. I've been here for 2 years already. And before, I played baseball in Texas, so that's how I got to OPSU.
What all are you involved in now at Panhandle State?
Well, I study psychology over here at OPSU, and I'm on the baseball team, so that's pretty much what it is.
Okay, let's talk a little bit about the scholarship event that you participated in this week in Mr. and Miss Panhandle State. It was very cool to see this event come back to campus. I know as a student myself, which has been a little while ago, I attended it and it was just packed. There were so many people there for the Miss Panhandle State when I was a student. And then I know before that, for the Mr. Panhandle State, one of our faculty members now, Steve Martin, had actually won it. So it's kind of neat to see how it's coming back around. It was organized, for our viewers who aren't familiar, it was reorganized by a student that just graduated, Reagan Higgins. She had the idea and came to us and did it actually as a marketing capstone class. And she worked specifically with Kim Tettle and AITP and PBL. Lots of help in getting the event going back together, as well as the student government. So let me hear your side of it. That's just the background for the viewers on how it came back. Why don't you guys tell us exactly what it was like?
I think you said it pretty much right. I think it was pretty well organized, and we knew exactly what's going to happen and what we're going to do, and everything was, you know, right on track since the beginning, since we signed up for it until the last event. And it was, I think it's a good tradition to keep. I think it, you know, keeps entertaining the audience as well as
Very.
Mr. And Miss Panhandle. And I feel like we certainly enjoyed it since the beginning, you know, throughout the interviews and then the last actions on the stage and everything. So it was something special.
Good. Let's talk a little bit about the actual event, Hannah. Can you describe to the viewers that weren't actually able to come and attend the event, even before that, you had a full day. Tell us how it went. What did you have to do?
Well, it was on a Tuesday, so of course we had to attend classes and do everything that you would in a normal day. And then at the end of the day, you got ready for your interview, and then you interviewed with the judges, with a panel of four judges. And then after that, we went and got ready for the actual event, where you came out and was first seen in your casual wear. And then after that, you changed into your evening wear and did your evening wear walk, and then we did the crowning right afterwards. And it was, we also did an onstage question in our evening wear, and it was such a great opportunity to get to public speak and learn how to make eye contact with people while you're up there putting yourself out there in such a unfamiliar situation, so.
I know, to me, I think it would take a lot of confidence to even decide to put yourself into the competition. You guys obviously have a lot of personality, as we can see with your crowns. You have a lot of fun with everything you do. I know that even shone through in your casual wear. Tell me a little bit about how you even decided to do it. Was it a scary thought?
Well, casual wear is something that I believe should represent your personality. And being a history major, I take history very seriously, and I believe it's something that goes very underrated. So I decided to dress up more as Rosie the Riveter and try to bring a historical piece to life on stage and show everyone, you know, hey, We're still out here, history's still great, something we should all recognize. But yes, it is something very, like, you have to sit there and really think about what is going to represent your personality through, like, items and clothes that you can wear on a stage, so.
Lucas, were you nervous to apply to the actual competition?
In a way, yes, and in a way, no. In a way, yes, because I've never done anything like this, so, people get tend to fear something that's unknown, but on the other hand, you know, there was really nothing to lose, and we could only gain this opportunity and be where we are right now. So
you guys are going to be great representatives for us. Tell me your thoughts when you heard that you won.
Oh,
Were you surprised?
Excited, surprised in a way. All emotions together. It was, I don't know if I've ever experienced anything like that, but I was super happy that it happened.
Hannah, what were your thoughts?
Well, I was extremely surprised. I think that there was a bunch of good candidates, and I honestly am just so honored still kind of can't believe it. So I was extremely happy and very surprised when they called my name. So
do you guys have any future plans? Like I said, I know you guys are going to represent us very well. I know you'll be called into action. Just today you had the opportunity to be into the parade. There'll be different events that you can attend and represent the university. Is there anything specific that stands out to you that you might want to promote besides just the university as a whole in this opportunity?
I would love to promote more history and education. Like I said, in my interview I went over how history isn't taken that seriously, and I've even written papers over how history should be put into standardized testing. So I feel like that's something I can use this platform to get out there with. I also believe that a lot of people they don't know too much about it, so it's not something people talk about. So it's really something that I feel should get out there and people should know more about. So I feel like as this platform, we could probably put that out there more.
And I've had some ideas that I tried to talk to different people before, but since I wasn't really vocal and people didn't know me too much over here, they didn't pay too much attention to it. So now I'm hoping that, you know, since we're kind of became a face of the university.
Definitely.
Hopefully the voice will be a little bit stronger. Like, for example, today, you know, you see everybody's out here and everybody's having fun. And I feel like throughout the year, there's not enough of opportunities to do such things. So let's say like in the plaza, there's, you know, such a beautiful space where people could be hanging out and or having a coffee or frappe or something like that. And so I'm hoping, you know, people start using the outside space more than the inside, because it feels good to be outside, doesn't
Definitely.
It?
And today's such a beautiful day. Mm-hmm. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for sharing, and congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Our next guest, we have Dawson, one of our rodeo superstars. I'll let you go ahead and introduce yourself.
I'm Dawson Dom. I come from Tomahawk, Alberta, Canada. 23 years old, and I ride bucking horses.
Dawson, what are you majoring in here at Panhandle State?
Animal science.
So what was it, I'm guessing rodeo, that brought you here to Goodwill?
Yeah, pretty much the only reason I did come down here was to rodeo and learn from Robert and Dan and Billy.
You knew the tradition of excellence.
Yeah, no, it has a reputation.
Okay, let's talk specifically about that tradition. You were a huge part of it this summer. You had a fantastic summer and really brought back a pretty awesome trophy to Panhandle State.
Yeah, no, it was definitely awesome to just be a part of it.
For our viewers, we're talking specifically about the college national finals. What was that experience like? Let's start talking about the process just leading up to it. You had a good year. Everything seemed to be going pretty well for you. Did you expect to find yourself in Casper?
To be honest, when I started the year, I didn't know what was going to happen. And then I had some luck pretty early on, and it just kind of continued through, and it paid off.
I know Robert, kind of one rodeo at a time, you're not really looking ahead, but of course you always have the goal to do well.
Yeah, no, for sure. I always had the dream that I wanted to go, but I didn't realize it was even possible until it kind of came down to the last rodeo.
Well, we're super proud of you. Tell us what Casper was like.
Oh, it was unreal. Yeah, I've rode in front of some big crowds, like Calgary Stampede, I've been in Cheyenne, but that was amazing. Like, the whole crowd is just electric, just with everything that happens.
Did you have any thought that you might finish as well as you did?
No, not even close.
Go ahead.
I've just never been really consistent, so I didn't actually expect to stay on everything, and I definitely did, and I'm good.
Did you have a game plan? Was it just that consistency, or were you just kind of one ride at a time?
To be really honest, I was just there to have fun. Like, I didn't even, like, you always, it, bronc riding's on your mind, but you just in there and meet some people and, yeah, see how it goes.
So talk about your finish. You ended up a reserve national champion saddle bronc rider and right behind your teammate, Jake Finley. What was that like? I mean, I just think that speaks volumes for the university, and that's so cool to get to do that together.
Yeah, no, it was unreal. Like, and then all through the year, it was me and him fighting it out most of the year for first and second. And then we went into the college finals, first and second from the region, and ended up first and second. So
I know competing against your teammate, you always want the best for them. I know that's the way it is within rodeo, just even if they're not on your team. But how cool is it to have a teammate like that that's always pushing you to get better?
It's unreal. I traveled a little bit with him to some other rodeos before college rodeos, and it was, yeah, he's always wanting to do better and wanting to help you any way you can. So it always just pushed us to get better and better, and ended up proving this summer, and even in the PRCA, both we had pretty good years.
Excellent. So together with the way you guys performed, you were able to lead your team to a national championship. What was that like?
Yeah, it was unreal. Yeah, no, I was without words.
Tell me about your plans for this year. I know you mentioned the PRCA, so let's talk first about college plans. You've got an audience.
Yeah, no.
Hey, guys. Dawson's killing it over here. Talk about your plans just college-wise. Maybe, I know you already said you didn't really have any plans going into last year, so does it change that this year? Do you have pressure? How do you feel?
No, I don't actually feel pressured up at all. But, I don't feel pressured up at all. Every rodeo.
You seem pretty
rodeo.
Laid back. You just go, and a lot of it depends on how you draw too. So you can't really go in thinking this is his exact game plan until you get there, right?
No, that's exactly it. And like even when we went to Colby, I had seen my short round horse go before, and it looked like a sweetheart. And I got on it, and it was not the same trip. But
so one rodeo under your belt for this season, college rodeo wise. Talk a little bit about PRCA. Will you be rodeoing pro as well as going to college, doing college rodeos?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, I've been flying up to Canada every weekend so far this year.
Oh my goodness. So how do you balance everything?
Oh, just learn to deal with no sleep.
Yes. All right. Is there anything else that comes to your mind that you want to share before we go?
Not really. No. I've coming to college here and learning from Robert and Billy is really helped things along, really improved me.
Good. Well, we're so excited to have you. Very proud of you and the accomplishments that the team had, and we wish you the best for this season.
Thank you, Danae. Appreciate it.
Our next guest is our assistant rodeo coach, Shelby Weeder.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. Shelby, you guys had an awesome summer. Tell us a little bit about the national championship. It was nothing new to you, I guess you could say.
No, it wasn't anything new. I guess I'm pretty lucky. We've been there twice, and we've come home as national champs twice. But our summer was awesome. For me, this one was probably more fun than the last, and I'm sure the next one will be more fun than this one. But it's fun to get there and see your kids that have worked so hard all year finally accomplish what they think is, you know, the biggest thing in their life. And at that time, it is. So it's a lot of fun to just go along for the ride.
We have a little rowdy crowd over here. Let's talk about some of your student athletes that you have for this season. I know, you know, it's awesome to look back and know you guys have accomplished so much, especially you, that you're going into your third season. You just finished up winning for the third time in a row, the Colby Community College Rodeo, the first college rodeo getting the season kicked off. Let's talk a little bit about what you think is in store. I know you're excited. I know you have big plans.
I do have big plans, and I've worked hard to get a good bunch of girls here. As you know, our men's team kind of has a reputation of its own, so we don't have any trouble getting those kind of guys here.
Seven-time national championship.
Yeah, so the guys seem to come, but we've worked hard to get a good bunch of girls here, and I think we finally have that bunch of girls. I'm not saying that it's going to happen this year, but I do think that we're building the right foundation that it is going to happen.
What will you guys be doing this year? Anything different or pretty much the same game plan of what you've been doing?
Our game plan pretty much stays the same. We try to give them as many opportunities to get in the practice pen as they can and keep as much stock around and do really whatever they need to do. We don't really make the game plan. We just help them form it.
You had a big, not only are you excited about the quality of athletes that you have, but you also had a great recruiting season. You have a larger number than in the past, right?
Yeah, our women's team is almost twice the size as it has been. For my knowledge, this is the biggest women's team that's ever been here.
Can you talk a little bit about how that determine what you were doing this summer, I'd like to give a special shout out to all the hard work that you guys put in, because you needed to build some extra pins for the amount of numbers that you were going to have.
Yeah, we recruited really hard, and when August rolled around, we realized that there was no way we had room for everybody. So we met with the administration and found a way to make room for all these kids that we got here. It's important to us that they have a nice place to keep their horses, because without nice places, without nice horses, you don't get good kids. So we spent the last 6 weeks really making that happen, and thanks to Mike Branson and Lanny Wilson, we have a really nice facility that has doubled the amount of horses we can keep.
Very appreciative for all the community support.
Yeah, we couldn't do it without them.
You've talked about the women's team as a whole. I know you have two individuals that'll be coming back that competed in Casper this summer, and you have a freshman that just won the women's all-around. Do you want to highlight anything individually that you're...
Yeah, of course, when a kid makes the college finals, it seems like they come back with a different attitude, and they have a little bit more goal set in mind. So I look for Caitlin and Kaylee Smith to both do great things again. They've been working hard, and they now know what it takes. Sometimes that's the hardest part about getting to the college finals, is not realizing what it takes. So they've got it, and we recruited a girl out of Kansas by the name of Bo Peterson, and I thought I knew before she got here how big of a competitor she was going to be. It's hard to tell though as a freshman coming in. It's a different ball game. Kids are older. You're competing against 22-year-olds and you're 18, but she prove that college rodeo was nothing new to her, and it's just another rodeo, and I think that we can look for big things for her in the next 4 years.
It's great to have, just as we talk with Dawson, you have some good team competition that's going to be pushing everybody to be getting better.
Yeah, I mean, you're only as good as the people you practice with, so the fact that we've put together a good bunch of kids, they're only going to make each other better.
And I know you have girls wanting to get up and rope at 6 in the morning and come back, and they're back out there until who knows how late at night. So that's awesome to see them wanting to work hard and that desire that they have to win.
Yep, it's awesome to see kids that want to practice that hard.
Okay, we've talked about the women's team, and we got to visit with Dawson. I know you have told me that he's going to definitely be a team leader for you. Let's transfer over to the men's team. Do you want to speak a bit about your future goals for them as well? I mean, of course, we all know we'd like to make it 8-time national championship.
Yeah, well, of course we would like to, and don't get me wrong, we're trying. We have a really good men's team. Of course, in the bronc riding, we're pretty strong. We have Dawson and Cooper Thatcher and Jade Tayton and Rowdy Chesser, and they've all come a long ways. Dawson's the only one that's made the college finals, but I don't look for that to be a big thing with them. Jade's also our only bareback rider, but he's really strong. He come out and won the all around, or won the, he won the bareback riding and made it back in the saddle bronc riding at Colby. So we look for a lot of things from him. And for the first time in a long time, our timed event side of men are actually tough. We had 9 of the 20 kids back in the team roping, and we had a calf roper and a couple of bulldoggers, but I think that we'll be something to be reckoned with on both ends of the arena on the men's side.
Very exciting. Well, we're looking forward to honoring you guys at halftime of today's homecoming game for your 7-time national championship, and thank you for your time today.
Thank you.
And we're back. We have a special duo here. You guys are joining us from the College of Business and Technology. Ding Winger, we'll let you introduce yourself.
My name is David Winger. I'm the Dean of the College of Business and Technology. I'm also an advisor for the national award-winning Phi Beta Lambda, or PBL.
Kim, tell us about yourself.
Sure. My name's Kim Tuttle. I'm an instructor of computer information systems, and then I serve as the advisor for AITP, which is Association of Information Technology Professionals, also nationally award-winning.
Okay, you guys, your teams, your group, clubs, organizations, however you best want to refer to it, are just amazing. You guys are truly making impacts that are going to take beyond the classroom, outside into the workforce, and just into their individual lives as well. Let's talk about your past years. You each have lots of highlights. You want to speak a bit about those?
Sure.
<They are. laughs>
So AITP has been competing since 1998. This last year was our 20th national competition, and we've got over 120 top 10 finishes, both regionally and nationally. This last April, we were really excited to come home with a first place in application development, as well as a first place in systems analysis and design.
So this last year, we got to go to Baltimore. And while we were there, we had at least 6 top 10 finishes in the nation, but we came away with another national championship. That makes two for us now. And Dr. Sarah Hitch and I are both, we both kind of feel like we understand how Nick Saban feels nowadays. Just all keep on winning these national championships.
Just collect them, right?
Yes, that's we just keep collecting. That's right.
Kim, why don't you speak a bit about some of those life skills that both of you team up to try to impact and, you know, make a difference in your students' lives?
Absolutely. So when you graduate with a bachelor's degree, whether it's business administration, computer information systems, accounting, industrial technology, it's kind of assumed that you're going to have a standard set of skills. But in our College of Business and Technology, we really work on honing in on those soft skills, giving you some mock interview opportunities, looking over your resume, taking you to contests so you can get interviews with employers, internships. And so we really pride ourselves in bridging that gap for the soft skills so that all of our graduates are very cutting edge when they get out into the workforce.
And it looks to be another exciting year. You guys have some special events that will be coming up that people will be getting invitations to, be seeing our press releases, that kind of thing. So we're excited for those. We're also very excited to honor you during halftime today and the accomplishments that you've had. Is there anything else that you would like to add about the groups? Just anything special you'll be doing, upcoming plans? Anything like that?
Well, so with PBL, whenever we got started, one of the mottos of our group became "We do stuff," and that's what. And we just keep on doing stuff, and so that just keep looking out because we're gonna keep on doing stuff.
Okay, why don't we go ahead and bring in some of our national championship students right now? We have some representatives for PBL. Thank you, Kim and Dean Wiener. I'll let you guys just go ahead and introduce yourself. Tell me where you're from and how you found your way to Panhandle State.
All right. My name is Cameron Hammett, and I'm from Boyd, Texas. And I found my way to Panhandle State through cross country, basically, is how I got here. So, yeah.
Very good to have you.
I'm Sarah Smith. I'm from Ulysses, Kansas. I am an accounting and finance double major. I found my way to OPSU because my brother actually went here before I did.
Okay.
I am Aaron Hammett, and I'm also from Boyd, Texas, and I'm also an accounting major, and I also found my way here through cross country as well, so.
Yeah. Well, you guys had an awesome summer. Tell me, one of you, whoever wants to, tell me how you finished up at Baltimore.
How Baltimore was? It was a really, really fun experience, honestly. I didn't think that accounting events could be so competitive, but they were, and it was a It's a really, really fun experience. Y'all want to say anything?
You got to say it, what happened?
Yeah, we're in suspense.
We won the Nationals. We're national champions in accounting
That's
analysis
awesome,
and decision
guys.
Making. So yeah, we ended up winning.
Okay, cool. Does one of you want to tell us what that means? Did you have a competition where you sat down and went against another team? How does it work?
All right, so the way it works is there's like two portions to it. So to get to, there's like once a stage before. It's just a multiple choice test, like 100 questions, I think is what it is.
Yeah.
And you answer that, and then if you get top 15 in that test, then you go on to the next stage, which is like a presentation part. And basically, you get presented like a case or like a situation, and you have to role play as like CPAs or accountants to how that person should carry out in that like particular situation.
Okay. So Dr. Fulton said after you guys won, he just wanted to get back there, hug your necks, tell you how proud he was of you. But he couldn't get there because there were so many people and future employers that wanted to talk to y'all. Sarah, do you want to tell us what that was like and what, how you see your future just because of this opportunity that you've had?
Well, it was an amazing opportunity that opened up giant doors for us. We actually had one of the judges that was a CPA come up and tell us that we did a fantastic job. And that's just a morale booster. It just
Definitely.
Makes you feel good to have someone who's actually succeeding at this tell us that we did a great job.
You guys did fantastic. We're so proud of you, so proud to have you representing Panhandle State. And we're excited to honor you during halftime as well.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Take a look around. It's been a gorgeous day on campus. We're so thankful for all our supporters, everybody, the community that came out. Starting with the parade, it was a little cool this morning. It's heating up. It's going to be a great day, and we can't wait to get to the field and see the Aggies take on Wayland Baptist. Thanks so much for joining us for this edition of Inside OPSU, and that's what's happening on campus.